heard tell the word just before he reached my soul. Let it sink me back home, the song I break my own. Came in to say the funeral gospel song, and I heard tell singer there's my own sing. And I heard once before you move before I die.
Thank you so much. We love y'all. Thank you. Things I learned in a hobo jungle. Were things they never taught me in a classroom. Just like where to find them while I'm bumming through Chicago in the afternoon. Hey, I'm not bragging or complaining, but I'm talking to myself, man, man. See, this old mental fat, I'm sure, didn't take a lot of doing. But I take a lot of pride in what I am. Well, I guess I grew up alone. I don't remember ever having any folks around. But I keep thumbing through phone books while I'm searching for my pappy's name in every town. I meet lots of friendly people, but I always wind up leaving on the lounge. I've never been nobody's idol, but at least I got a title, and I take a lot of pride in what I am.
I had to tilt my hat down a little bit. The light is a little bright.
Is it too bright in your
house? I thought I was going to get sunburned.
I told him it looked like the Marlboro
Man. Bright as my, that light is as bright as my future.
I do believe your future is bright, especially all the stuff you've been telling folks today that you were going to be a politician and all that. And then I was not mistaken. I heard them. We've got a country music cruise coming up in January, and I heard you telling several people here that that was your ship.
It's one of them.
One of them. So you got multiple.
Yeah, pretty much all the Royal Caribbean ships are under my belt, and then the one we're going on with them.
Yeah, is this something in your family?
Yeah, my great-grandfather owned the Titanic.
We'll see how
that y'all know, out. Let me tell y'all something that y'all didn't know. Did you know that the swimming pool on the Titanic still has water in it?
Listen, now I was going to ask you something. I heard you talking to a man out here tonight, and you was trying to get him to spend his honeymoon with us on the cruise. You're telling him he needs to bring his wife on the cruise. But that man that you were talking to, I don't believe he's going on a honeymoon. No, he looked kind of...
He was 98 years old.
98?
He was 98. He had just got remarried.
What happened? His wife passed away or what? His first wife?
No, they divorced.
How long had they been married?
62 years.
Well, I would have just waited it on out.
It was a surprise to her, too. But he married a girl that was 20 years old.
Oh my.
And I said, man, that could be fatal. He said, well, if she dies, she dies.
Man.
People say the craziest things.
They're crazy. And I tell you, and musicians do the craziest things. We have I tell y'all what, music business is a weird business, and we've gone into several different other business avenues together, and a lot of it has to do with livestock.
Yeah, we did. We went into a lot of livestock business, and the last thing we went into was pigs.
Right, yeah.
I bought 165 piglets off of Amazon. I was going to use for breeding. You know, I needed 165 females, and I got 162 males. So just them, what, how many? Two, three. How many is it? Three of them? Yeah, I thought about having them transmitted to females, but that could get expensive. And a whole lot of Budweiser. So, just pour it in a trough. And then come up. Anyway, where was I at? I told y'all running for president. hold on. It's going to come back to me in a minute. Okay, I had them three pigs turn out to be females. I needed all of them to be females, but only three of them turned out to be. So I carried them to Smithfield, North Carolina. I don't know if y'all have ever been there. But carried them there to this pig breeder. And he was going to breed them pigs for me. And I left them there and went by the next day and got them. And I said, how do I know if they're bred? He said, well, if you go out there tomorrow morning and they're eating and stuff, then got grazing, they're bred. They took. I said, okay. So I got home next morning, went out there. They were all just standing around out there in the field. So I called him again and he said, bring them back over here. So I did. Next morning, went out there. They were all standing there. This went on for a month, me carrying these pigs back and forth to get bred.
Every day.
Every day. Until the last day, I didn't even feel like going out there. So I told Chris, I said, if you will, go out there and see if those pigs are bred or whatever. And he said, okay. And he came back in a few minutes later, said, I got good news and bad news. I said, what is it? He said, well, the bad news is they're not bred. He said, but the good news is, it's two of them already loaded and one sitting behind the driver's seat tooting a horn.
I remember the year Clayton Delaney died. They said for the last few weeks that he suffered and cried. It made a big impression on me, although it was a barefoot. Then he got religion at the end of the land. Now Clayton was the best guitar picker in our town. No, I thought he was a hero. I used to follow Clayton around. I often wondered why Clayton, who sang so good to me, never took his guitar and made it down to Tennessee. Well, my daddy said he drank a lot, but I could never understand. I used to pick up an Ohio pipe. And Clayton used to tell me, boy, you better put that old guitar away. While there ain't no one in it, it'll lead you to an early grave. Well, guess about a minute, Clayton taught me how to drink booze. I was gonna carry on somehow. I'd give $100 if he could only see this. I remember the year old Clayton Delaney died. Nobody ever knew it, but I went out in the woods and I cried. I know there's a lot of big preachers that know a lot more than I do. But it could be that the good Lord likes a little picking too. I remember the year Clayton Delaney died. She's a
hypnotized a crowd of 5,000 people that was there just to hear me speak. Could you make a little bit more noise?
Go ahead, I'm
sorry.
Amateur.
You didn't even cut the standby on. Anyway, I was hypnotizing a crowd of 5,000 people. And I had me a pocket watch. I was doing that watch. I was like, raise your left hand. Everybody raise your left hand. Raise your right hand. Everybody raise your right hand. It was going really good. And then I dropped the watch and I said, oh, crap. Took them 2 weeks to clean that place out. Be surprised the mess that can make.
Now you see, this is why I get nervous every time. Every time you start to talk, I don't ever know what you're going to say, and it makes me uneasy. You know what I'm saying?
I think you're better off just to say whatever. I think if you're better off just to say whatever, can then nothing tell back. Like, I'm upset. There are some empty seats out there, and when we got up here, I saw them pick their seats up and they said, I ain't gonna listen to the Malpass brothers.
And is that bothering you?
Guess what? I don't wanna see them either. You know that really hurts your feelings.
Does it? I think you're just.
My feelings are hurt.
Are your feelings hurt?
So I want y'all to tell them people, them dude, you're just sitting next to the empty seat, tell them today hurt my feelings. They ain't getting a Christmas card from me this year, and they ain't invited on my boat.
Do you need a hug?
No, not right now. I need more than that.
Well, I can't help you there. Now, Taylor can play the mandolin. He's a lot more talented than I am. He can play multiple instruments. That's not like people that can use their left hand.
That's Chris. That's called an anorexic.
Okay, good to know. All right, do we have any Lubin Brothers fans out here? All right, here they go.
I know who ain't Lubin Brothers fans, people at least.
church y'all to be in. You got your hood. Do you feel better?
My leg got it. I feel like I had a Labrador up here. Hey, if y'all need somewhere to sit, there's some spots.
We all always get some many requests for Luke Brothers song. I don't even know what I was going to do now. I got all that happening.
You're going to sing a song.
I was going to sing a song. And we had a special request to do one of my favorite Luke Brothers songs. See if y'all remember. When I stop dreaming, that's when I stop loving you. The word that I've ever been heard in my life, the first time I ever wanted to die, was the night when you told me you loved someone else and asked me if I could forget. When I stop dreaming, that's when I'll stop loving you. In the snow, you may take the pebble and teach it to grow. You may teach all the raindrops to return to the ground, but you can't teach my heart to forget. When I stop dreaming, let's in a crowd, labor camp. Stand now in this memory I revive.
where my daddy raised a family there with two hard-working hands, and tried to feed my mom's hungry eyes. We dreamed of something better, see my mom's face was strong, but as kids we're just too young to realize that another class people put us somewhere just below. One more reason for my mom's hungry eyes. Mom never had the luxury she wanted, but it was not 'cause my daddy didn't try. She only wanted things she really needed. One more reason for my mom's hungry eyes. Well, I remember daddy prayed for a better way of life, but I don't recall the change of his size. Just a little loss of courage as their age began to show, and more sense in my mom's hungry eyes. Mom never had the luxury she wanted, but it was not 'cause my daddy didn't try. She only wanted things she really needed. What more reason for my mom's hungry eyes? Lord, I still recall my mom's hungry eyes.
Hey, oh.
what a great talent. We hope we get to come see y'all again. We love you so much. Sing with us on this one.
We don't smoke marijuana in Muskogee. And we don't take our trips on LSD. And we don't burn our draft cards down on Main Street. Cause we like living right and being free. We don't make no party out of love. We like holding hands and pitching glue. And we don't let our hair grow long and shaggy. Like the hippies out in San Francisco do. And I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. A place where even squares we still wave old glory down at the courthouse. White lightning's still the biggest thrill of all. And the boots are still at start, man for wear. Be better opens and those won't be seen. Why football is still the roughest thing on our campus. And when we sing our anthem, we don't take a knee. And I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. A place where even square can have a ball. We still wave old glory out at the courthouse. Waving old glory down at the courthouse. And you're a Mr. Virginia, USA.
God bless y'all. Thank you so much. Thank y'all so much. We love you. Thank you. How about it for the Malpass Brothers? Thank you so much. We had a, Taylor, we had a special request. He's going to tell you about it.
We did. As well as all the other stuff that I have accomplished in my short period of time, I have also went to acting school. And they're actually going to get me to play Brad Pitt's part in the next Top Gun. So
Brad Pitt so, didn't have a part. That was Tom Cruise. Tom Cruise was in Top Gun, not Brad Pitt.
They're the same person. It ain't gonna matter no way whenever I get it.
So,
look, they're even walking
out. Now you, so.
Don't worry, we just pass out $100 bills when we get done. Y'all go back to camp, we gotta get there before bedtime. Anyway, you're at a festival. You should be having fun, sitting around a campfire tonight. You know, cooking marshmallows. Y'all having fun? I bet y'all are gonna stay up till midnight and raise the roof. Thank you.
Come here. I think you need a brotherhood. Do you need a brother?
No, we'll do El Paso and then I'll okay.
Out in the West Texas town in El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina. The music would play and the meal would whirl. Blacker than night were the eyes of the leader. Wicked and evil are casting the spell. My love was deep for this Mexican maiden. I was in love, but in vain I can tell. Then one night a stranger came in, wild as the West Texas wind. Dashing and daring, a drink he was sharing with wicked Pauline of a girl that I love. So in anger I challenged his right for the love of this mate, down with his hand for the gun that he wore. His challenge was answered in less than a heartbeat. The handsome young stranger lied dead on the floor. Just for a moment I stood there in silence, shocked by the foul evil deed I had done. Many thoughts raced through my mind as I stood there. I had but one chance, and that was to run. Out through the back door of I ran, out where the horses were caught. I caught a good one, it looked like it could run, up on his back and away I did ride. Just as fast as I could from the West Texas town of El Paso, out through the badlands of New Mexico. Back in El Paso, my life would be worth it. Everything's gone, but nothing is left. But it's been so long since I've seen the young lady. My love is stronger than my fear of death. I saddled up and away I did go, riding along in the dark. Maybe tomorrow tonight nothing's worse than this pain in my heart. And at last here I am on the hill overlooking El Paso. I can see Rose's cantina below. My love is strong, it pushes me upward. Off down the hill toward Molina I go. Off to my right I see five mounted cowboys. Off to my left ride a dozen. They're shouting and shooting, I can't let them catch me. I have to make it to Rose's back door. Something is dreadfully wrong, for I feel a deep burning pain in my soul. Though I am trying to stay in the saddle, I'm getting weary of it. I am weary, I can't stop to rest.
I'm so tired!
Now I see the white puff of smoke from the rifle. I feel the bullet go deep in my chest. From out of nowhere, Molina has found me, kissing my cheek as she kneels by my side. Cradled by two loving arms that I'll die for. One little kiss and Molina goodbye.
God bless y'all, Virginia. We love you.
Thank you so much. Once again, let's hear it for the Malpass Brothers, ladies and gentlemen. We'll look forward to the next time we get to meet with the Malpass Brothers. And we'll look forward...
Somebody's ready to party tonight.
Taylor, I want to tell y'all, that's right, we got to Ray Price. We got to do a Ray Price. And I want to tell y'all, there were some ladies out there a while ago. This is why I'm scared of him. I don't ever know what he's going to say. These ladies came up a while ago, and they recognized Will and Langan, and it was kind of dark, and they recognized me and Taylor, and they said, I had seen all four of y'all somewhere before, but I can't remember where it was. And Taylor said, we all used to be strippers. And I was turned red. Now, she couldn't see it. And the lady went, that's right, that's where it was. We had a question at all. How many of y'all here know Wayne Prophet? Anybody know Wayne Prophet? Mr. Wayne booked us, and helped us years ago when we first started in the business. So if you can't stand us, you can blame him. But he loves Ray Price, and we do too. And we had a request for a Ray Price song. We're going to do this special for him. Wayne is a walking miracle. Some of y'all may know he's been very sick, but the Lord has blessed him and can heal. And he's here with us tonight. So we're going to do this one for you. I wish I could fall in love today.
Always much too busy with the blues. I wish that I could fall in love today. But if I did, I'd know I wouldn't stay. You'd come between us like you always do. Somehow they never measure up to you. Today.
We love y'all, Virginia. Thank you so much.
Once again, the Malpass Brothers. Outstanding show. As always, we love the Malpass Brothers. You guys be safe. We'll see you next time. Hey, and don't forget their festival, Mother's Day weekend, in Denton, North Carolina, the Denton Farm Park. That's always a lot of fun, so keep that in mind.